அடுத்து நான் மாஷா அஸ்வாக் இர்ஷாத் இஸ் இட் தி ஹேண்ட் ஆர் தி வாய்ஸ் இந்த டாபிக்ல பேச வருமா அன்போடு
First of all, I would like to extend my heartfelt welcomes and all blessings to all those who have been with us this evening. Is it the hand on your hand? Or is it the fingers that you have onto your hands? Or is it the voice that comes out of your throat that's going to make a difference? Just think. Do you think the pen that you hold on your hand and write a lengthy essay, you go on and on writing books, is that worth it? Or a couple of words that you just tell is going to make a huge impact on the person sitting right in front of you? Never underestimate the strength that you have within yourself. We all are mere oysters. All of us, each and every single individual here, has a pearl within ourselves. It's just that we don't open the pearl and see what's inside. We all have a pearl. But we are reluctant to open that pearl. And we are reluctant to see what we really have inside us. You might have all the qualifications from A to Z. A for architect, Z for zoologist. You might have piles and piles of certificates nicely locked within your cupboard. But at the end of the day, if you don't know to put that millions of certificates into words, if you don't know to tell your audience what you really have to say, your entire pile of certificates, throw it in the trash. Not worth a single cent. It's like this. You take an entire mathematical equation and you multiply it by zero. What's the answer? The answer will be zero. So no matter what millions of certificates, no matter what millions of paperwork achievements you have, at the end of the day, if you don't know to speak with people, if you don't know to intermingle with those within your society, you are nothing but equal to the bull on the road. You know that we, as human beings, we are different from the cows. We are different from the dogs. We are different from the giraffes. We are different from the hippopotamus. Take any botanical, zoological animal, we are indeed different. So, why is it that we still portray ourselves equivalent to those five-sense animals? Scientifically, it's proved that we are the only sixth-sense species ever to roam on the surface of this earth. So if we have that sixth-sense that differentiates the good from the bad, if we have the ability to think, so why on hell are we not ready to unleash the potentials we have within ourselves? Why is it that still we are reluctant? We still want to confine ourselves within the four walls that we were brought up, within which we were bred. Why is it that we don't open our eyes and go out into the external environment? All these answers really need contemplating questions that we have to ask ourselves. Just take a single moment of your precious time and just think. Okay, I have a cat at home. How am I different from this cat? This cat, even if we give the most delicious of food, or even if we give a small morsel of bread, it's not going to understand the difference. It will just think that it's a food and it's going to eat it. But it's we who know our priorities. It's that we who know what's up and what's below. From the beginning of your life, When the doctor comes and cuts your umbilical cord and brings you into this world, all the way till you go 6 feet down, you are going to undergo many moldings. We are all mere clay. It's just that we have to mold ourselves. It's just that we have to reshape ourselves to unleash the best that we can. I quote from a report of Professor Jeremy Seedlings. He says that the number one fear that any human being has on this earth is to come and speak on this stage. Number two is death. So just imagine, at a funeral house, if you go, majority of the people would like to lie in that casket than coming and delivering the funeral sermon. That's the pathetic situation that we have. We have to break free from all this. Why is it that still we are within a mindset that, come on, it's speech. He will also come and speak, no? She will also come and speak, right? So why is it that, I have to go? I'm no one. I don't even get marks. I don't even get any reward. I don't even have any qualifications. So why is it that we are still within such a mindset? Why can't we break free? Opportunities come and go. They are like the tides of the waves that, linger within yourself. Opportunities come today and they go tomorrow. So whatever the opportunities that come onto you, it actually comes onto your feet. A person just comes and knocks your door and says, sir, today you have to give a speech, just come out. So see, opportunities come right onto our doorstep. So even if all these opportunities come to our doorstep, why is it that we give this two-letter, very cheap word? No. Why have we made this cheap word no to be something really very fancy? Why can't we say yes? It's just one letter extra. It won't even take a couple of milliseconds to pronounce. So why is it that we don't say yes to something that comes onto our feet? Avenues are open for you everywhere. So whatever the avenues that come onto you, don't be a fool and say no. If you need to learn swimming, it is compulsory that you get into the pool. Without getting into the pool, how much ever books you study or how much ever lectures you see or how much ever videos you watch, you will never be able to swim. If you have to swim, you have to get into the pool. It's just like that. If you have to speak and inspire an audience in front of you, it's mandatory that you come up here. Without coming up and foregoing all your fears, nothing is going to happen to you. You have to learn to prioritize whatever you have. Let's say you are going in a village and there is a very deep river that is infested with crocodiles. Okay? So, at the same time, there are a couple of logs also onto your side. So, if you need to cross from one bank to the other bank, through a river that is infested with, crocodiles, will you swim? Now, let me see. Will anyone here swim through that river? No, right? We have logs, we have brain, God has given us the ability to think. So use that log, build a bridge, and then go on to the other side. Speech is like this. You might have scattered ideas within yourself. Your audience is somewhere else. They still need you. And the bridge that you build is your speech. And if you say, oh, I don't want to speak, I'm very scared. So if you are within this mindset, it's like you are going and swimming within that infested crocodile. Never underestimate your individual capabilities. All of us have the same two eyes. All of us have the same two ears. All of us have all our five fingers. Now, for example, if you take these five fingers that you have, A majority of us have all the five fingers. Let's say I want to eat my lunch today, the plate of rice that I have, I want to eat it using only this one finger, my index finger. Is it possible? Come on. Is it possible? No. If I need to eat, there should be a contribution from two or more fingers. If I need to eat, there should be contribution from two or more fingers. But without the initiation of one finger, you can't carry on with your eating. That's how. Change is not just a word that is there in your dictionary. You can just open it and see what's the meaning of change. That's not change. It's something that really has to come from within yourself. It should come from the core of your heart. Individually, we have to change. It is then that the entire society can change. No matter how much of sermons you listen to, no matter how much of videos that you have a look at, no matter how much of books you read, what you act and what you go and do is that is going to amount. We all have different skills within ourselves. The skills I have, it might be absent. The skills that he has, those skills might not be in me. Because we two are genetically non-identical. So therefore, whatever we have, stand up, rise. If an opportunity comes on to you, never say no. Don't be cheap people. Never say no. Say yes, no matter even you fall. A toddler, when he has to walk, no one is a Superman, no. All of a sudden we come out of the mother's womb, we can run 100 meters race. No one is like that, no. We have to crawl. Then we'll fall down. Then we have to cling on to certain supports. Then only we can walk. No one is Superman, no one is Batman, no one is anything. It is a gradual change. Whatever we have to do, it is actually a gradual change. So even if you are someone who doesn't know how to speak, I'm pretty sure that this particular program that they have formulated will come in handy. So, we are the queens and kings of tomorrow's throne. Our parents might be with us today, but we don't have guarantee that we or anyone here will be there tomorrow. So the time that you have now, utilize it. The moments that you have now, make use of it. It's then that you are going to see your true potential. So ladies and gentlemen, we all should stand as traffic lights. Always be red towards negativities. Red negativities, you stop. You can't go after me. And always be green towards opportunities. Opportunities that come to you and take the maximum of use of it. So all the best and wish you a better, brighter career with speaking. Thank you.
Thank you, Master Ashfaq Irshad. MashaAllah, wonderful speech. Nanenikiren, illara ullangalai thottikkondirikkumennu. Vaalkaiyila manidhan oru padi mel selvathendral, allathu sila vidayangalai saadhippathendral, eppadi seiya vendum, eppadi saadhikka vendum, engu aarambikka vendum endra pala udharanangalodu நன்றிகள். அடுத்து இந்த ஜி டாப் சம்பந்தமாக என்னுடைய